My name is Vicky Holmes, and in a few days, I'll be celebrating another birthday. Now, normally I'd gripe about getting older, but this year is different. I feel amazing. And as you can see, I still look fabulous. See that white woman who just walked by? Yep, she works for me. My real estate company is doing great, but more importantly, I have a fine man who I know is ready to take our relationship to the next level. Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on. So, not that I've been eavesdropping or anything, but I overheard you earlier today when you said you wanted to take things to the next level. I think it's a brilliant idea.
Okay. I was gonna wait, but
wait. Wait.
Now, I know this is a business trip, but I can't wait to relax. And look, our villa has a sauna.
You deserve some relaxation.
Oh, I do, don't I? You know, I don't want you to feel any pressure to get me a birthday present, but if you were thinking about
I'm moving something. To Seattle, Vicky.
Seattle?
I know the timing's bad, but I got a great offer from another firm.
Wait a minute, Duncan. You've been looking for another job?
You always said be prepared when an opportunity presents itself.
An opportunity for this company, my company. What are they offering you?
It's not about the money. It's about the potential.
Potential, Duncan? Are you kidding me?
All right. Forget work. What about us? It's already a challenge trying to find time to spend together, and now you want me to get on a plane and fly
cross-country? Vicky,
what?
Vicky, I just think it's best we go our separate ways. Sorry.
What the f*** just happened?
After visiting the gun range to let off some trifling, no-good ex-boyfriend-related stress, I decided to visit my best friend, Sophie. We've been friends since high school, and she always knows how to cheer me up.
Vicky!
Hey.
What are you doing here? Come in!
I was in the neighborhood showing a house. I thought I'd surprise you. You okay?
Yeah, it's me being surprised.
Stop.
Hi. Hey.
How are you two doing?
Oh, we are fine.
Yeah?
Oh, and no nausea this time. Thank God.
Good. I see you've redecorated again.
Yes.
You know, I should hire you to do my show homes.
You should. I would love that.
Yeah.
Yes, especially when school is out because I have nothing to do.
Oh, well, how's Jackson?
He's fine. Good. He moved out last week.
He what?
Yeah, you know, he's 15 now, so we decided that it's best for him to live with his dad. Yes, Kyle and I discussed it and we decided together. It's fine. Are my hydrangeas beautiful?
Sophie.
What? Look, Jackson wants to build a better relationship with his dad. That's a good thing.
But what do you want?
Right now?
Yeah.
I really want a fern in that corner right there.
You know we are not talking about plants.
Look, I'm going to have my hands full when this baby comes, and this is just the best thing for everybody. It just is. It's good.
Okay.
So you and Duncan are going away for your birthday this weekend?
Duncan took a job in Seattle.
Seattle?
Yeah, can you believe that? I taught that scrawny little fool everything he knows about real estate. If it wasn't for me, he'd still be in the mailroom.
Honey, I'm sorry. But I read this article about women who sabotage themselves when they take on men as projects.
Well, he needed a job. I mean, how else was he gonna take me out to fancy places and buy me things?
So I know you have your conference in Trinidad, but I hate for you to spend your birthday alone.
I don't have to go
alone if you come with me to Trinidad.
Look, I'm only speaking at the conference one day. The rest of the time, I'm free. Come on, I'm staying in this beautiful villa by the water. Come on, let's party like we used to when we were younger.
Like with balloons?
No, with strippers.
Stop!
Come on, remember our grown girls getaway?
Grown girls getaway?
Oh my God, that was so fun.
Oh, well, then let's bring it back. I leave this Saturday.
Oh, I can't go on Saturday.
Why?
Because I have that dance class. Remember you told me to sign up for the ballroom dancing? So I did.
Well, girl, you can dance your ass off in Trinidad this Saturday. Come on.
This is so soon. I mean, what if the girl's not able to make it? It's going to be so expensive. Too much.
I only have 2 tickets.
Well, what's a girlfriend's trip without the girlfriends? No, we have to do it when we all can go, and let's do it another time.
Okay, so you're gonna let me go on my birthday weekend by myself?
No, look, I just think we all should go, and it's Camille's birthday too.
All right, fine. If the girls can make it, then I'll pay.
You sure?
Yeah, well, Camille's gotta pay me back.
Okay.
Raise that left leg in the air, knees bent.
I put my hand up on your hip. When I dip, you dip, we dip. You put your hand up on my hip. When you dip, I dip, we dip. I put
Why are you all looking at me?
When I dip, you dip, we dip. You put your hand up on mine.
It might have been her. She was listening to Big Daddy Kane earlier. Hello?
Hey.
Hey, Vicky. I'm sorry it took me a minute. I'm in the middle of yoga. And can I tell you something? These yogis are extremely judgmental. I think I'm going back to Zumba. What's up?
Sophie and I are going to Trinidad this weekend for a grown girl's getaway. Are you available? My treat.
A grown girl's getaway. On you. Hold on. Let me check my schedule. Yes, I am available. Will you please just send me the info right away?
Awesome. I'll email you the itinerary. Bye!
Okay, bye. Oh, yeah? You have a stage name to go with that dance?
Mom, this is my room. You're supposed to knock.
No, this is my room.
Okay. I believe those are my shoes. I did buy those jeans. What are you doing with my vest on?
Ugh!
Oh. Hey, girl, what's up?
Lauren, Vicky, and I are going to Trinidad for a grown girl's getaway for 5 days, and Vicky's paying.
Girl, I can't get away for 5 minutes, let alone 5 days. And I damn sure don't want Vicky paying for anything for me. You know how she is. I got you, girl. You don't need to use your money. Here, let me get this. Let me get you some food.
Let me get you something to drink. No, I'm good.
Come on, but it's your birthday. Do you have any plans?
Yes, I'm going to do what I always do on my birthday. Go to dinner with Calvin and the kids. Hold on 1 second. It says you need 10 things for the time capsule, not 5, Mr. Slick.
I know you could count.
I'm sorry, I can't go. Maybe next time. Anyway, I think I'm gonna be in jail this weekend. Let me call you back. Kayla! I'm gonna kill you!
Who had the remote first? You had the remote first? Give him back the remote. Y'all need to stop this. Camille, come get your kids. I got work to do. I don't have time for this. Give it to me. I said give it to me. Boy, don't test me.
So, I'm in.
Islands in the sun.
Paradise.
Oh,
Vicky, this is beautiful. Wow. Look at that view. Oh,
yes.
Oh
nice.
Gosh. Hey, what are you doing?
What, the islands carry lots of germs that our bodies are not immune to.
Yes. Whoa, Lauren, your shoes, put them on.
Oh, leave me alone.
No men, no stress. I can't wait to relax. What about you, Sophie?
Mm-hmm. No stress.
I'm gonna have an affair.
What?
Well, you two get to have new haircuts. I should get to try a new man.
Camille, don't say that.
Okay, well, then I won't talk about it when it happens. Lauren?
Well, you know me, girl. I just came to party. I want to soak it all up. You know, the culture, the music, the food, the rum.
Okay, now that's what I'm talking about. All right, I'm going to go do my speech for a couple of hours. When I get back, let's party, right?
Hey, you guys, I hope you have your slippers because these floors are not clean.
This place is dirty.
They should have got a maid.
Hello.
This entire house has been thoroughly cleaned by me, the maid.
Please remember the house rules. There's to be no loud music,
no excessive partying, and absolutely no drug use of any kind.
Why is she looking at me?
Welcome to Trinidad.
Thank you so much. I'm Sophie.
Thank you.
You are stunning. What is your name?
Thank you, ma'am.
Can I get one of those? She's
not nice. She's just gonna be nice. Sophie! Put down the Lysol. Camille.
Yes.
Put down the phone.
I need to take some pictures.
Put down the phone. And for God's sake, Lauren, stop feeling on yourself.
I'm hot.
All right, we have 5 days to do absolutely nothing. So what are we gonna do?
Live it up.
Live it up, ladies! Live it up! Live it up!
She's going to have fun.
Well, I hope she stays in our eye line. What is that smell?
That's weed, silly girl.
Weed? Who is smoking weed at a dance place?
Competition. I'm gonna sign up.
You are?
Yes. You know you look ridiculous, right?
There's too much smoke in here.
We're outside.
Well, it's strong smoke.
Oh my gosh. All right. Ladies, are you in line?
What's it to you?
Well, I'm trying to sign up.
Lauren, let's just go do something else that's fun. They have other fun stuff.
No, because this is really fun.
Perhaps you should listen to your friend, Dr. Cardigan.
Hey, sister, do you realize that bullying is actually a form of terrorism? So actually right now you're being a terrorist? Are you a terrorist?
Well, did you know?
Whoa. Now, here's the thing. If I were you, I would back up. Because there's a new queen of dirty whining in the building, and her name is Lucy Slaw. So get it together and bring it. Excuse me.
Yeah, here goes.
Thank you.
What she said.
Hello.
Yes! We are down to the final four contestants who will be our newest Calypso Queen. Let's give these ladies a round of applause. Woo! Now, ladies, you got 30 seconds to show us what you're working with. It's time to whine!
Murder, call it murder. Where's your mind?
way, I MJ'd her ass right off the stage.
I did, actually. Mm-hmm.
You guys, we shouldn't have left Vicky.
What?
I mean, come on, you know the golden rule. We go together, we leave together.
Yes, okay, but Vicky is a grown woman.
And so. That's not the golden rule.
Look, did you see the guy?
He looks dangerous. He's fine, and so is she. She's fine, alone with him. Good night, I'm going to bed.
Good night, champ.
I don't see how you could just sleep knowing that Vicky's just out there.
Yeah, you know, I'm not going to be worried about what Vicky's doing. I need to worry about how I'm going to get me some.
Camille, you're joking, right?
Why would I do that?
Have you and Calvin gone to counseling?
Oh, my God, no. Calvin and I aren't even speaking. And when we do speak, we're fussing and fighting and arguing over just everything. Sometimes I just long to be single.
I read somewhere that 50% of women who are married with children are unfulfilled. So you're not alone.
That's good, because misery loves company.
No, you're not miserable. You're not. You're discontent.
Oh, thanks, Doc.
Hey, make a party.
What? I can't believe you brought him here. It's after midnight.
I didn't realize I had a curfew.
Come on, boo.
Did he mean for me to go with him when he did that? I cannot believe that she is sleeping with a native on our first night here.
Come on, let's go.
Give us a minute, would you? Okay, Lauren, what is wrong with you?
I was just checking to see if his pubes had come in yet. No, seriously, I mean, what are you doing with him?
Hell, you look down his pants. I think you can answer that question. And don't judge me.
No, I am not judging
you.
He is very cute. And you know how I feel. Have fun and do you. Damn! What the hell is that smell?
Please stop.
Sophie!
What?
You all right? What did you eat, girl? A dead body?
I feel sick.
Yeah, well, you smell sick.
Leave me alone!
Fine, no problem.
Oh, my God.
Hey, good morning.
Well, good morning to you,
how
sunshine.
How are you?
No, how are you?
I'm fantastic. Wow.
I have so much energy right now, I cannot even tell you. I even woke up this morning thinking, you know what? It would be kind of nice to give Calvin some right now. If he wasn't getting on my last nerve. No, seriously. I mean, quiet as is kept, that was my thing back in the day.
Oh, okay.
But then again, it's really nice to not have anybody ask me for anything. Mommy, I'm hungry. Can I get some eggs?
Babe, where's my tie? And can I get some now?
No. Where's Sophie?
She's in the bathroom exercising a demon.
See, I told her to leave all that curry alone. She was like a mad woman at the buffet last night.
Man, we have been here one day. I am already the dance hall queen. She's in there crapping her insides out, and Vicky is officially a cougar.
Wait a minute. Is he still here?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Probably because he's packing like a Polish sausage.
Is that good? Or I never had Polish sausage.
No, that's very good.
Really?
Oh, honey.
Hi, boo-boo. I mean, not boo-boo. Boo-boo is the wrong choice of words. How are you feeling?
Oh, my God.
You know, they say diarrhea is a sign of triplets.
Oh, yeah.
What is that, some kind of urban legend? And I don't have diarrhea. Lauren?
No, I am not getting involved in this. But you know what? You could probably use a little sunshine. Come on.
Good idea.
Let's get you ready to go. Come on, babe. Come on.
Dead goat in here? Nasty.
Sausage? Kielbasa. Okay. Look at her. How old do you think he is?
Oh, stop. She's having fun.
I hope you're enjoying yourself, Miss Thing, because in a couple more years, you won't be able to bag anything remotely close to that.
Oh, please. Whatever, Camille.
Ladies, this is how we deserve to live.
Yes, it is.
Thank you so much for this trip. It's so nice to be here.
Thank you, Vicky.
Well, at least you two are very welcome.
Hey, you guys. Look, I found this. Beach blowout, grand prize, $10,000.
It's a contest and stuff. We should do this. It sounds like fun.
No, it sounds like work. I didn't come here to work. I came here to relax.
Yes, and I am already a winner. I have nothing to prove.
Okay, well, fine. You guys just be lazy and sit around and do nothing.
Thank you. Aren't we a little old for that anyway?
Excuse me, speak for yourself.
I did. And I can speak for you, too, because we are the same age. Middle age. Plus, kids take about 4 or 5 years off your life, so my days are numbered.
Well, I also heard trifling men knock the years off.
That, too.
Damn, in that case, I could die any day now. You know, I have had my share of sorry men. But when I think about it, I really wasn't happy until I was with Malik.
Oh, my God. Girl, you know how long ago that was.
No, and he cheated on you. With some old skanky girl, I'm sure.
And she's lucky I never found out who she was. He was my soulmate.
I don't believe in soulmates.
What?
What about you and me? You guys been together for how long now?
4 years.
Aww.
4 years.
I know that look. Is he still making it happen?
What?
Really?
Oh, God.
Well, speaking of having sex.
None of your business. I know where you're going.
Vicky, now I know that you are having sexual intercourse while we are here. I know you are. And I just hope that you are using the proper contraceptive because you don't want to get pregnant by this young guy.
And the after-school special is being brought to us by Sophie.
Don't worry, she can't get pregnant with powdered eggs.
Why would you say that?
What?
You know she wants to have a baby. And obviously, it is possible.
It was a joke.
Goodbye.
Okay, stop.
Goodness.
Let's go to the water.
Come on. No, I'm not going in the water. I just did my makeup, and I don't want my hair to get wet.
You know I drowned when I was little, had to be revived. The whole thing, I'm good. We and the kids, we don't do water.
That is sad. And if y'all don't do water, then why are you at the beach?
To relax. Remember?
Yes. I'm going to get a drink.
Listen, how many do you think I need to get a buzz? It's getting expensive.
A little stronger, please.
Earn something on me. If you want more, you'll let me know.
Sophie! Hey, Soph!
Huh?
Hey, huh? Sophie. Babe, which bag?
What? I don't care. Pick one.
Soph. Drag.
Really? You're gonna change your purse right here on my lap?
Yeah, because I have to.
Oh, my God! Camille! Really?
Okay, you have got to relax or you're gonna have a stroke. Cut it out.
Camille.
I have never in my life smoked weed. I have never done that.
Do you want crack?
I don't
want
to come in your
house.
No, but I don't want my baby exposed to it either.
Do you know how much smoke you inhaled last night? Your baby's going to come out with dreadlocks. Just relax.
It's not funny.
Hey, dinner reservations in 20 minutes.
Okay. So, I'm sorry you don't feel well.
It's okay, honey. You guys go on home.
I'll meet you guys outside.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
So, listen, a guy's going to stop by the house.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Scully. He's going to give you a package. You're going to give him this, okay?
Okay?
It's enough for an ounce. All right? Love you. See you, babe.
You think Sophie's okay?
Yeah, she's fine. She just wants to sleep. You know how it is when you're pregnant.
No, Camille. Actually, I don't.
Oh, yeah, she's fine.
Scully send me.
Hello?
You looking for something?
Oh, no. No. Me. It's my friend Camille. Vicky.
Whoever. Tell me who you need.
Well, she left this money. And she says she needs a pound.
A pound?
Yeah.
Y'all partying big.
No, we're not partying big.
Lady, she called management and said we have an hour to get out. So
I can't believe we got kicked out because of you, Camille.
Technically, this is Sophie's fault.
Sophie? I'm not the one that's fraternizing with drugs czars. You are, Camille. Just say no. Just say no.
Okay, calm down. I can't hear.
This is Scully. He keeps blowing up my phone. Did you pay him?
Yes, Camille. I gave him the money you gave me.
Okay, well, I only gave you enough for an hour.
Well, how am I supposed to know? I don't know. I don't buy drugs. I don't know what
could go wrong tonight. Perfect.
Okay, thank you for checking yourself.
Shinanse. Where my money?
Listen, it's only shouting and it's not necessary. She say everything was in the envelope.
You see all this messing up? You're always messing up. I'm fed up with it, all right? Grab my money or else.
Good luck.
So apparently, there's an IT conference in town and all the hotels are booked solid. You guys, I don't even know where else to call.
Scully keeps calling.
Speaking of which, Camille, everyone knows that when you come to an island to experiment with drugs, you don't give the drug dealer your real number.
Really? Everybody knows this?
Well, you know what, guys?
You guys better figure this out because I am not catching a case because of your two shenanigans. Just pay the man.
She needs to pay him because here's a school teacher who doesn't know the difference between a pound and an ounce.
No.
Yes.
No, I am not. You should have never got me involved in this illegal drug trade.
I can't.
Hey, listen. Ralph's uncle has a boutique hotel, and he's pretty sure they have vacancies.
Right.
Yes!
Something's going right.
Oh, it's called The Palace.
Ooh. Oh, and that's
nice. I know this is the same. Oh, my God.
This don't look like no palace to me.
Definitely gonna need more Lysol.
Man, this is some bull.
Look, as much as this place disgusts me, we're not leaving. I didn't pay for this trip for it to end like this. And it's my birthday weekend, damn it! Well, let's not forget, it's Camille's birthday too. Look, we'll just look for another place tomorrow.
Wow.
A bar.
All right, ladies. Okay, it's not the beach, but
if we get drunk enough, it'll feel like it.
My treat.
Awesome.
No, what am I gonna do?
Don't worry, I got you. I'll get drunk for both of us. All of us, really.
Yes.
I'm not doing no dumb contest.
So, what do you guys think? It's nice, right?
It's a nice dump.
But we are very thankful. Thank you, Ralph. Thank you.
And I used to have a booty like that. How much do you think she gets paid for that? She probably get a lot of money, huh?
Ow! What the hell?
Just don't. No. Everybody knows. You never look a prostitute directly in the eyes. No.
Who the hell is everybody?
Look, Vicky, this is a very respectable establishment. It's been in my family for years.
There are whores in the lobby.
But we don't judge. Because Camille and I were whores back in the day.
We were. We was good, too.
Oh, my God. It's not even like a 3-star or a 5-star or even a 2. Thank you, baby. Thank you.
I catch your cheats and ass.
Ruth, what are you doing here?
I come to see the whore. You're sleeping around with.
Hey. I am certain you are not pointing your ill-manicured finger at me.
Well, I'm certain she did.
Ruth, don't start this madness now, please.
You ain't find a little too old to be sleeping at my man?
Who are you calling old?
Okay, hold on. Ladies, let's place the blame where it belongs. On Ralph.
Hold on. You is not the same dance girl from the club?
Yeah, no.
What was your name? Fat Hips?
No. Honey, it's Loose Hips. Loose. Or you could just call me Winner.
Well, hello.
Ralph. That's what you like? Fat Hips, Crow's Feet, and a Miss Jane Pittman.
Let me tell you something you broke down, Rihanna wannabe.
Tell her!
Clearly, you don't have what it takes to hold on to your mind, which is why he's all right. Over here up on her old ass.
What?
Let me tell Ollie something. Say something, one more thing, and you're going to be picking up your grill off the floor.
No, please don't.
What's up?
Okay, that's right. You see, officer, we were just here celebrating our birthdays. We don't understand why these girls would pinpoint us as targets.
Officer. Honestly, I don't know how I'm gonna recover emotionally.
And sir, I'm 5 months pregnant. See?
Okay. Let me get this straight. Those girls were harassing you all.
Yes.
But you don't want to press any charges.
Oh no harm, no foul. We just think it's so sad that girls today don't know how to conduct themselves.
It really is a shame, but
Officer, I see it all the time at the shelter where I volunteer. Such a good person.
Okay. Well, you ladies have a good night, okay?
No, thank you, officer.
Drive safe.
I will. Yes. And please try to stay out of trouble.
We will.
And you ladies, free to go.
They say over here, tell you.
Miss.
You better wash your back.
Miss, please.
What she said?
Yes, miss.
Wait a minute!
Did you see my sticky move?
Okay.
My bob is weird! I haven't had fun like that since, like, the sixth grade.
Camille, you were amazing! You were like Mayweather and Ali and a little bit of MMA in there.
Yes! Yes! Okay, but wait a minute. What? Did you see the way she went down? Bloop! Bye, Petra.
Yeah, okay.
Dang, that was so much fun.
Oh, that was awesome.
Y'all ready to go party?
What? Girl, please.
What?
Oh, God.
Oh, you ain't no fun. I'm about to go hang with the hoes anyway. Hey, listen, what time y'all get off?
I think I found the girls you called me about. Yeah, they're at the palace.
I can't believe there's not one decent hotel with available rooms.
I told you. And the conference is here for another 2 days.
I just wish we could have stayed at that condo. That old housekeeper. She had it out for me from the start.
What time did Camille say she was coming back anyway?
I don't know, but I'm hungry.
Well, you girls are going to have to eat without me because I'm going to Ralph's cricket game.
You're dissing us for Ralph?
I'm not dissing you. I'm just leaving for a few hours.
You are spending the whole grown girl's getaway with a boy.
Well, he's a very nice boy. Look what he left me.
Oh, my gosh. This is cute.
Isn't it cute?
He probably spent his whole allowance on it.
Ha, ha, ha. Look, you said that this trip was not about men.
I did say that, but that's before I realized that the Trini men are so fine.
Okay, honestly, I wouldn't mind seeing some cute Trini men at a cricket game.
Yes, come with me.
No, stop it. No. I'm not eating alone. I'm not. And you keep spending all this time with Ralph, and you're never going to see him again after we leave.
Well, all the more reason. I mean, he is actually thinking about attending school in the U.S.
Okay, look, Stella, I've said this before, and I will say it again. You don't need a man to validate you.
I just want to have a good time.
Oh, my God.
Hi, ladies.
Camille, You look hot.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. When did you go shopping?
I know. Turns out Mama still got it.
Yeah, and she should share it with her husband. Look, you spent the whole night out with whores. We were worried about you.
I wasn't.
Well, I'm fine, Mother. Thank you very much. And speaking of fine, I met someone. Turns out he is a lawyer. He took me shopping. And we have a date. Tonight. Excuse me.
Camille!
What?
Okay, wait. You're being too vague.
Well, I'm not being anything.
I cannot believe you are doing this.
I can. Listen, ladies, I'm going to be downstairs. I don't want to deal with this.
Well, at least he's a distinguished professional and not a prostitute.
He's not a prostitute? And I can't believe you would talk to me like that after I paid for the trip.
Well, there it is again. If I got to hear one more time about how you paid for this trip, we know you paid for the trip, Vicky. Clearly, you couldn't pay for any class.
The baby's hungry.
You know
the
what?
Baby's hungry.
You are sad and pathetic.
See, now I'm sad and pathetic.
You have to be intoxicated just to get through your pitiful little life. No wonder your husband didn't want to sleep with you.
Malik didn't seem to mind.
Oh, hell. What did you say? You slept with Malik?
Well, clearly he was tired of your boring bond.
That sounds like something a slut would say.
Look, you guys, that was 15 years ago. We're ladies now. We're adults.
You've been calling me names since we were freshmen. What? Am I supposed to be hurt now? I'm not. I've already heard it all, Vicky.
Oh, Camille, she's just a poor girl from the hood here on scholarship.
Whatever.
Funny you would say that because you're still that poor little girl from the hood here on scholarship.
Listen.
What? So no, what, you're gonna come
I'm
out
here? I'm not gonna do
Stop
this.
It. Stop it! What?
You shouldn't have said that.
Oh, please, Lauren. Don't stand there and look at me like you don't have any skeletons in your closet. When you told me Ethan was married, what did I say? I said, hey, girl, do you.
What?
And you, pregnant by your ex-husband hoping to win him back. You two ain't any better than me. In fact, you're worse. At least I'm honest about my issues.
Ethan is married?
Sophie, I didn't tell you because I knew how you would feel about it, all right? But this is a completely different situation.
No. I don't even know who you are.
Yes, you do.
No. We talked about how Cal's affair destroyed us. You sat there and you listened to me pour out my heart. And the whole time you were doing the same thing.
I wasn't doing the same thing, all right? Okay, Ethan is unhappy, but he can't leave, okay? They have a business together, and if he walks out, he'll lose all of his money, and she doesn't care what he does.
Is that what he says to you? Is that what he says? It's women like you who destroy it for wives like me.
No, all right. Okay, now you are comparing apples to oranges, all right, Sophie, because you left Kyle.
No, I didn't. I didn't leave him. He left me. I didn't have the guts to leave. I would have stayed forever. Yes, he left me for her, and I'm pregnant. You know, it's people like you. And Ethan and Cal, you guys prey on women like me.
No.
Yes, you do. Wives who believe in love and commitment. I loved him. I wanted it to work.
Okay, Sophie.
Yeah, boy,
I didn't. I'm sorry. Ethan, it's me. Listen, I'm just calling to see if everything's cool. I thought I would have heard from you by now. I left you a message. Actually, left you a couple messages. If you could give me a call as soon as you can. All right. Thanks. Bye.
Vicky,
What are you doing here? Get off the field.
No, Ralph, I am ready to go to dinner. It's my birthday.
Yo, what you doing?
Okay, let me finish playing the game now.
How long is it gonna be?
Stop playing. I've got it.
Ow!
Could you stand on your own?
Yeah. Yeah, I can stand on my own.
It's crazy.
Thanks.
So you'll meet me later?
Sydney, you are beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
So, as this is your first time here, what would you like to do? I was thinking we can go sailing.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
Sailing?
Yeah, no, I don't do water. I don't go in the water, so, yeah.
Oh, so what would you like to do then? Camille.
I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, you know what? I'm having an all-around bad day.
You want to talk about it?
Actually, I don't. It's just that my girlfriends and I aren't speaking right now. Okay. Like, literally, because of something that happened years ago. I just don't understand, like, why are we bringing this up again? Like, we were pretty much kids back then. Why are we talking about this? Like, we're on vacation and it's just, I don't know. Never mind, it doesn't.
Well, maybe if you do talk about
it. It's just like, really? Really? Yeah. Now we got to talk about this? Like now all of a sudden this is an issue.
It's not an issue. We're just talking. We're just having a drink.
Do you want to talk about it?
Not really. What about talking about the water?
You know what? I'm sorry. I'm really normally a lot of fun. I'm actually a good time. Really.
I believe you, Camille.
Oh, well.
When am I going to get a chance to see this fun side? So you were sucking on that cherry.
I can't do this. I'm married.
Married?
Yes, I'm married. I'm married. With kids.
Shucks.
Multiple kids, actually, so we could just get the check.
Sophie. Come here.
Get off!
Oh. Did Sophie come back? Where's Sophie?
I don't know. Call her.
Okay. My cell phone was right here. Here is my... Where's my phone? Where's my purse? Oh my God, where's our stuff? Where is our stuff? Have we been robbed? Oh my God, I think we've been robbed. Vicky.
Oh, Ralph again.
Vicky, wake up. We've been robbed.
We've been what?
My jewelry.
Oh my God, where is my cell phone and my money?
Okay, what the hell is going on?
Hello?
You owe me $10,000.
We
won $10,000 for my weed and my time. But your pregnant friend here going to be in a lot of trouble.
Is Sophie with you? Let me speak to her.
Don't hurry her. We're going to call the police. What am I
saying? Talk to them.
Hey, you guys. I'm fine. He hasn't hurt me.
But I feel a little sick.
This place is filthy here. It's all these mannequins and statues, and he doesn't smell good at all. He actually stinks.
You want to call the police for me? Huh?
Call them. How you feel, I'm fine.
Yes, when you call the police and you talk to Sergeant Rogers, my uncle, tell him I said hello.
You're a long way from home, Birdie Girls. Yeah, in my city now.
And you have until midnight to get my money.
Oh, my God.
I hope for your sake, your friends get the money.
Ooh, what do you have to spit on me? I hope you know that the United States of America, they don't negotiate with terrorists. I have to pee. Mrs. Scully!
Okay. What are we gonna do? All right, you guys, they could hurt Sophie, all right? So we just give them the money. We just go to the bank and we get the money and we just give it to them.
How? Lauren, we can't just walk into a foreign bank with no ID, no passports, and just get money.
All right, so we call the police, guys, all right? They can't all be crooked.
Why didn't I think of that? Why don't we just call the police? Tell them we just purchased a pound of weed, but the drug dealer kidnapped our girlfriend because we didn't pay him his money. Yeah, that's a good idea. You want to go to jail?
No, I don't want to go to jail. You don't
want to go home.
You better figure this out. Come here, because this is your fault, you piehead.
Shut up.
I know how we can get the money.
How? No, this is not a good idea. No.
You have another way of getting $10,000 in one day. Look, if we lose this, we go to the police, whatever happens, happens.
Please, this is just the wrong attitude, all right? We can do this, all right? Just get your mind right and let's win this thing.
Okay. Come on,
right?
Camille, come on. Yes,
fine.
Let's do it. Excuse me, sir?
Hi. All right. Okay, all right.
Okay.
We have some beautiful ladies here. So what's your team's name?
Oh, I think we should
birthday babes.
Birthday babes, awesome. All right, everybody, listen up. Our newest team is the birthday babes. Give it up. All right, awesome. So these are the rules. Remember, all team members must sign the last page. The first competition starts in an hour, so good luck!
Okay.
Thanks, Isaac.
All right.
Mr. Scully? Scully! Scully!
What?
I'm hungry. I would like a box of crackers and water, filtered, please.
No.
No? Are you gonna tell a pregnant woman no? Because she's hungry and wants something to eat? Oh, you think that makes you all big and bad? You think you're a big and bad man? Ooh, I'm Scully. I sell weed. I kidnap pregnant ladies, and then I don't feed them. I bring them to my kidnap warehouse, and I just make them starve to death. Well, what if I decided to just have this baby right now? What if I just decided to just push and push and push her out, and here she comes along with the placenta and the afterbirth and the amniotic fluid and the blood and then a live baby that you're gonna have to cut the umbilical cord.
All right, enough. What do you want?
I would like a box of crackers and water filtered, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
There is no way they're gonna let us compete without a fourth person.
But we don't even know anybody else here. What about Patra? We know her, kind of.
Oh, you gotta be kidding.
No,
Do you have another option?
Hey,
I am not fighting again. This time she is on her own.
Yeah, she's getting out of problems. Yeah.
Hey, girl! Hi! Remember me? I know. I come bearing gifts. Listen, I know this is going to sound crazy, but would you be interested in being one of our teammates in a competition that we're doing?
You have to be joking.
No, I'm actually not.
That girl's never going to want to do this.
I know. All right, well, there's a lot of people here. I'll go try and find someone else.
She's coming.
Oh, you guys remember Ruth, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I hear all you need some help.
What'd she say?
I said, I hear all you need some help.
Yeah,
you do. Well, I just usually just come here for the free beers, but I suppose I could work something out.
I apologize, so I think you should apologize.
Just want to apologize.
Sorry.
Sorry.
What you say?
I said, I'm sorry.
Okay, she's... Okay.
I didn't know he had a girlfriend.
Very pretty.
Gorgeous.
Oh,
y'all
yeah.
Are putting a lot on it.
You know, it's great when we as women can work things out amongst ourselves, come together, you know?
Girl power.
Well, I'm glad you say that because I won the dance trophy.
What'd you say?
I won the dance trophy.
Oh, hell no, I ain't giving you my trophy. I won that dance trophy.
Oh, that's all right. Much better. Well, I'll see you ladies later. Bye.
Okay. Bye, bye, girl.
I get you. I can't wait to see them make tree ass of themselves.
Is your water?
Is it filtered?
Drink the water.
Well, I'm not drinking dirty water. I'd rather stay thirsty. It's not good for the baby.
Fine.
But... Scully, okay, come here. I'm just gonna have a little sip on her baby, right?
Oh. Right?
Thank you. Oh, Scully. I'm gonna need another box of these. I'm eating for two.
Okay, baby cakes. Is that all you need?
No, actually, I would love...
This is not room service.
Oh, God! You have got to do something about that spitting. It is do you do that on dates? It's a turnoff. Scully, I still have to pee.
Contestants will have 30 minutes to make the biggest, best, and brightest carnival costume. Let the costume-making competition begin!
Okay, so who's going to be our model? Ruth?
Hello, if only be lonely going to make me look crazy, only lying.
What did she say?
Not me.
I'll do it. Okay, well, guys, honestly, I don't even know where to begin here.
Okay, you know what? I got this. I know more about fashion anyway.
Hello, take your time. You just need plenty of feathers. It ain't nothing big.
All right,
okay.
Here.
Oh, feathers.
All right, feathers. Here. One more feather, right?
Ow!
Sorry.
It's hot.
Sorry.
Oh, my God. I'm going to poke you in the eye with this thing. We don't need any more.
Okay, listen, I think we should put this around your waist.
Yeah, what's your name? You have to wrap it around your wristwatch. I'm from here. What?
I know you're from here. That looks crazy.
Girls, that doesn't even go with my vision. Oh, right. We're ready. Oh.
Okay, wow.
Isn't
that
it
came out beautiful, you guys.
Thank you, guys.
No. Yeah. Pageantry.
Whoa. You okay?
Let me help you.
Ow! Sorry.
It's all right. I told you it was too much.
It wasn't too much. It was beautiful. All you had to do was hold your head up. You're like this. Just hold your head up.
You did it on purpose.
I did not do it.
Right, so I know what I
want to win.
This is about Sophie. Come on.
No, this is about her always trying to make me look bad.
No, you didn't. Oh, no, you didn't.
Girl, I guess I did.
Thank you, Scully.
You're welcome.
Hey, Scully. Come here.
What?
Come here. I want to ask you something. Scully. That's not your real name. That is not what your mommy named you. What's your name? I mean, come on. We spent all this time together in your kidnap business. Please, just, what's your name?
Marion.
Marion?
Marion.
Oh, Marion. I like it. I like it. It's a pretty name. It's very masculine. I like. Thank you for my crackers, Marion.
You're welcome.
Hey, Marion, can you come here 1 second, please? Can you untie me? Please, I'm not going anywhere. I'm bringing me crackers. And plus, I can't run. I'm pregnant. My doctor advised against it. So, you got me. Please, it's cutting off my circulation.
All right.
Good, so I get the blood flow to the baby.
Okay, so we're lucky I convinced him not to disqualify us. But you two need to squash this.
Let me tell you something.
No. Camille, if we don't win this, we're going to jail. Did you see Broke Down Palace? Okay, nobody did. But the point is, what they did to those two little white girls is nothing compared to what they're going to do to us.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying... fix it!
So why did you sleep with him?
Sophie is God knows where, and you want to talk about Malik?
Yep. I do.
Okay, but you only found out about him yesterday. You've always had a problem with me, so explain that.
Well, this is gonna sound dumb now, but... Sophie was my friend first. And then you came around, and then she didn't have time for me.
You're serious?
Yeah. You came with all this street cred, and all of a sudden, Sophie had this new friend that was cool.
Listen...
And you thought you were better than us.
I never thought I was better than anybody.
Yeah, you did.
No,
yeah, you did.
I didn't. I was just trying to fit in. Then I heard you were talking junk about me. That's why I slept with Malik. I knew you thought I couldn't pull a dude like that. It was payback.
I always thought it was you. My instincts were right. I thought it was you. And then Sophie convinced me that I was wrong.
Look at that. We're in paradise. Why are we even talking about Malik? He ain't thinking about us. He's all somewhere, God knows where, doing God knows what.
He's in Jersey. He's got a beer belly and he's starting to bawl, too. Facebook.
You are funny. You know, I'm so sorry about Malik. I really am. If it makes you feel any better... Karma has come back around, because I'm surely paying for it now.
Why are you complaining all the time? I mean, if you're unhappy or you're bored, I think that's your fault. I don't think it's karma. You have a beautiful family, Camille. And if you'd stop worrying about what you don't have, maybe you'd appreciate what you do. You got a lot.
All right, so one of our favorite foods here is doubles. Now, when you come to Trinidad, you have to eat doubles. The spicier, the better. So when all of the doubles are gone, hit the buzzer. The team that finishes their tray first wins.
I didn't know these were spicy. That messes up my stomach.
And go!
Give me that, boy. Go away!
Oh, okay.
Watch it! Camille is not a joint!
Oh my God, Ruth is funny. Look at her, she's moving the doubles. Oh.
And we have a winner!
No.
Give it up for the Dixie Chicks!
Vicky, why did you stop eating? And what were you doing?
I was trying to get it in my mouth.
I don't feel good. You know what? We're gonna lose, right? So we might as well just quit, because I'm doing the very best that I can, and you two are not helping.
I have 5 P's. I'm doing the best I can.
Really? 5 P's? That's the best you can do, Cum Laude? Really? You need to do better. Both
hey.
Of you.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. My God, I've never seen her so angry.
Yeah, me neither. Let's go find her. Lauren, it's gonna be okay. We're gonna get Sophie.
Oh, so you do remember Sophie, because you two haven't been acting like it. You guys, I'm frustrated because you can't even put your differences aside long enough to fight for her. You know what? And Vicky, this was your idea.
I know, and God, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Guys, if we're not going to commit to this 100%, then we might as well just quit.
No, we're not going to quit. We can't quit.
Good. I'm glad to hear that because I know you're both fighters. Vicky, you started a company, what, 5 years ago? And now it's worth millions of dollars? And Camille, you hold it down with your husband, your 3 kids, 365 days a year, year in, year out, without even a thank you?
Oh, no, damn no, right. We can do this. And
you know what? You...
You're so pretty!
Right.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, thanks. Okay, so guys, we can do this for Sophie. So on three, Sophie.
Sophie.
1, 2, 3, Sophie!
So handy to them. I thought they would have given up by now. They have hearts.
Competition so far, but we're finally down to 2 teams. The 2 teams competing in our final round are the Trini Girls and the Birthday Babes.
Yeah!
All right, okay. Now, this final test is called Dipping for Beads. We're going to place 100 beads at the edge of the ocean. Your team will rush into the ocean and dig 4 beads.
Ladies, we can do this.
No, yes. No. You're going to have to do this without me.
No, Camille, we need you.
No, I can't. You know I don't do water.
Now, the winner of this contest
wins the competition and the $10,000 prize! On my whistle!
One, two!
You guys can do it, you'll be fine! Oh, go fast! Hurry up, go! Let's go! Come on, you guys! Dang it! Dang it!
And the fourth Mandibian is finally entering the water! What do they have that time?
We couldn't have done this without you.
I am
so proud of you.
Oh, God.
Watch my volley when I want some of this money, eh? If y'all are crowned the champions, I would like to receive a portion of the earnings, please.
All right, everyone. All right. I have the results, and it is so close. Now, the Trinity girls have found 23 beads. And the birthday beads are found. 22 beads for the Trinity girls.
Watch now. All right, sorry for Ollie and everything, but I want my dance trophy.
Who cares about your stupid trophy? Now we don't have the money to get our friend back from Scully.
Scully and Alzheimer?
You know Scully?
Unfortunately, yeah.
Okay, well, Scully took Sophie. And we can't get her back because someone stole all our stuff and we have no money.
Oh, yeah, that's too bad.
Oh, my God, I can't.
All right, fine. If you just get your stuff back, you can get your friend back?
Yes.
Well, let's just say I might just know where your things are.
Well, can you tell us? Was this all for nothing? Really?
That is what has happened when you try to take people's man.
Okay, I said Dr. I was sorry about that.
Oh, you want your stuff back or not?
Yes.
Sweet,
yes.
Right here.
I can't believe that heifer had our stuff. And she speaks perfect English.
Perfect English.
I'm not giving her my dance trophy.
So what, you're just going to stand there? Give me more money.
Wait a minute. If you want the money, you give us the girl.
Look, you're watching too much Scarface, little girl. Do not play with me. Give me my money.
Camille, like, just give him the money so we can get out of here.
I think we should give him the money. We don't have time for
this. Yeah, I forgot. You're the expert pothead.
Like I said, money, girl.
Look, you don't use my product already, and you owing me, eh?
We didn't even smoke anything!
That's not my problem! Give me my money! And you, hand me my money!
Okay, everybody, shut up!
Thank you. Marion.
So she making friends with him?
Marianne, I'm just going to walk over. They're going to give you the money at the same time.
Don't make those sudden moves.
Let's just do this so everybody can go home. I'm really tight, okay? Please.
Fine.
All right. Let me just...
Sophie! Hi, guys! Oh,
all right.
Okay. Bye, Marion.
Scully.
Bye, Scully.
All right, Sophie. Yeah. Never kidnapping a pregnant woman again, eh? Never. Stressful.
You was pregnant? I thought it was just an ex-fat American.
Hey, you try eating crackers and water for 24 hours and see if you're not hungry.
You guys, no one is going to believe what happened to us on this trip.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, I know. No,
but I still have my trophy, so I have proof.
You feeling okay?
Yeah, I feel okay. I was just thinking, I've been with Cal since college. It's going to be really weird raising this baby alone.
Well, you're not raising this baby alone. You've got us, the aunties.
This whole experience has changed me.
Well, this has been a life-changing whole weekend.
Mm-hmm. You guys, we used to be so close in college. I mean, I know we see each other, but we don't really talk.
It's like, I need you guys. That's all I was thinking about.
Because you guys are my sounding board. You're my voice of reason. Lauren, I'm so sorry I yelled at you. I don't understand it, but...
Okay. Honestly, Sophie, I don't understand it either. But, you know, I'm still learning.
It's just that I love you, you know, and I want what's best for you. I mean, you're my best friend.
I thought I was your best friend. Jinx!
No, I said it first!
Did I miss something?
No, never mind. Okay, well, can I talk now?
I guess.
Okay. Thank you. So listen, since it's my birthday, yeah, well, okay. Since it's our birthday, I think we should do something special. So,
okay.
You know I'm giving out homework. I say that we each write down the things that we want to change about ourselves.
Oh my God.
We put the paper in a bottle.
Oh.
We throw the bottle in the ocean. Right? Okay. Message in a bottle.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, and then we start fresh. Brand new, clean slate, pledge to be better women.
I love it.
Yeah.
It's the gift that keeps on giving.
Yeah.
It's very Oprah.
Well, you know how much I love Oprah. But I can't take credit for it. It was one of Martin's homework assignments, and I thought, yeah.
That's so cute.
That's cute.
What if you don't have anything you want to change?
Really?
All right, I'm kidding.
I'm actually not kidding.
I've decided to adopt.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah, you know.
For Sophie.
Thank you.
I don't want your baby not to have a playmate.
Okay, well, I got three kids. I can loan you three.
No, I bet yours.
And no.
I'm kidding.
Hey, Camille, be quiet. You know you love them babies.
Of course, I love my
babies. Thank you. You're going to be a wonderful mom.
Yeah.